my matriculation pictures. I was a happy girl, just floating through life.
At 19, I got into one of Nigeria's best universities, but it was nothing like I imagined. One of my lecturers demanded to have sex with me in exchange for my exam results. I refused.
Never ever imagined that I'll be a victim. Unprovoked, I didn't do anything.
The harassment forced me to drop out. This is the fate of many female students across West Africa, where sexual harassment in universities has long been a problem. For more than a year, BBC Africa Eye has been investigating the issue at the University of Lagos, or UNILAG. After talking to numerous students, one name kept coming up. Dr. Boniface Igbenehu is a senior lecturer in French and a local pastor. We sent an undercover journalist to meet him, posing as a 17-year-old student seeking admission to UNILAG below the legal age of consent.
Don't you know you're a beautiful girl?
Over a number of meetings, he was consistently inappropriate with her.
Do you know, and I'm in my 50s, okay? What will shock you is that even at my age now, if I want a girl of your age, 17-year-old, all I need is to put the tongue out, put some tongue out, and I'll get it.
Dr. Boniface promised her admission to UNILAG if she passed her exams.
I'll give you admission.
Are you serious?
I'm an associate professor.
He was also very open about wider harassment inside the UNILAG senior staff club.
There's an upper part of the staff club there, where lecturers and the teachers, they take them up there to go and smooch them.
Ah!
Romance them.
Eh? The thing they to do?
To smooch, touch their breast, touch their head.
Jesus.
It's a club. So they call it the cold room.
We later secretly filmed inside the so-called cold room ourselves. We found a number of senior lecturers dancing with women we were later told were UNILAG students having a birthday party. While we were investigating in Nigeria, an Africa Eye team was also on the ground at the University of Ghana. Here, we followed up allegations against Professor Ransford Jampo, a political scientist and a well-known commentator. We sent an undercover journalist posing as a student at the university, and he agreed to become her mentor. A few weeks later, Professor Jampo called on a Sunday afternoon, asking to come to her home. She managed to persuade him to meet at a mall instead. Throughout this meeting, he made numerous inappropriate remarks. He also asked her to marry him. He then said he wanted to kiss her.
I grabbed her and kissed her, and here, by the time I released this, she all the fibers want.
As she began to leave, Professor Jampo made one last move. Professor Jampo told the BBC he vehemently denied sexually harassing our reporter or any student. He told us he treats all students with respect, care, and genuine affection. He claims he was entrapped, which the BBC strongly refutes. The University of Ghana says it considers the allegations of misconduct leveled against Professor Jampo to be extremely disturbing. It has a proactive policy on sexual harassment and is committed to rooting out the problem. Back in Lagos, our footage captured physical harassment by Dr. Boniface.
What a kiss.
Do I want
a kiss?
Dr. Boniface wrapped his arms around her.
Sir?
No, sit down, sit down, sir. I don't want this car. Come close.
I've gotten the cold room idea.
Come close, come close.
Okay.
Sit down. Sit where?
It's okay.
Look. I'm scared of me.
Yes.
That's what I'm doing.
My baby, my baby.
No, wait, that's what I'm doing. I'm not going to hang.
Thank you, sir.
He then released her.
It's okay, sir. Okay.
UNILAG told us it dissociates itself from the alleged behavior of Dr. Boniface. It has a zero tolerance policy towards sexual harassment. it did not comment on the so-called cold room. Despite repeated requests, Dr. Boniface has not responded to the allegations against him. Kiki Mordi, BBC News, Lagos.